Many parents in a Fargo neighborhood were surprised to learn that 6 high-risk sex offenders live down the street from an elementary school bus stop.
It may be because they don't show up on the state's map of registered offenders. Valley News Team's Devin Fry dug into the issue.
A tool used by many people to monitor high-risk sex offenders in their area may not give you everything you need to know. The North Dakota Sex Offender Registry map uses icons to show where registered sex offenders live. However, not all are being shown. This was recently discovered when many parents were surprised to learn that 6 high-risk offenders were living in a building just 250 feet away from a bus stop to a local elementary school.
The interactive map is provided for free online by the state of North Dakota and is supposed to show you where registered sex offenders have their address listed. Now, yesterday when we contacted Fargo Public Schools about the bus stop concern, they were also unable to locate any sex offenders in that area on the map. So we're going to go ahead and show you exactly what we're talking about now.
To find a sex offender near you, you go to sexoffender.nd.gov and type in the address in question. Once you search them, a list of offenders comes up, including the 6 that live at 1122 2nd Avenue South. Once the map comes up, it should have icons showing where these sex offenders live. However, we know 6 live in this address right here, but there's not an icon to be seen.
There are numerous apps and websites that you can use in order to see if there are registered sex offenders in your area. Now, while the map provided by the state of North Dakota did not show that those sex offenders were living there, one particularly helpful website we found was Family Watchdog. There you can see that on the map they do show the sex offenders living in that area.
We reached out to the North Dakota Attorney General's office for a reason why these offenders were left off the map, but were not given an explanation. Reporting from Fargo, Devin Fry, Valley News Live.
We also contacted the Attorney General's Office for North Dakota for an explanation. They simply replied with a link back to the map.